So welcome back. I'm Jess. I'm joined by Mark Sherwood, Fluke's Technical Sales Manager for the UK and Ireland. And today we're going to introduce you to the Fluke SMFT1000 Solar Multifunction PV Tester. So, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
Thank you for joining us. Please, could you give us an overview of the Fluke SMFT1000 Solar Multifunction Tester?
Okay. Well, this is the unit that we have here. SMFT stands for Solar Multifunctional Tester, as you say. Mm-hmm. And what's happened is we've brought a unit to the market that enables the user to be able to test the whole of a solar panel array and all the electrical measurements associated with that. To add to that, we've added what's unique on this product, and that's an IV curve trace.
Okay.
The IV curve trace can be displayed on the screen, which is something that not everybody's product out there currently does. So that's something that Fluke have brought to the table for this unit.
And so could you just elaborate on what it's used for? Troubleshooting, predictive maintenance, condition monitoring, that sort of thing?
Right. The SMFT is used in multiple areas for obviously testing a solar farm. The traditional solar farms that we've all seen as we probably travel up and down the motorways in these big A roads, we see masses of solar panels in the fields. These obviously have to be installed and commissioned. That's where the solar kit can come into its own.
Okay.
This would help the installer do all the necessary 6 AC tests to comply to the regulations so that they know it's electrically safe and sound for obviously energizing and putting onto the network. So that's what this would do, and that's from a commissioning perspective. As you can appreciate as well, there needs to be some follow-up actions as well. They need to be maintained, they need to be routinely tested as well, which again is what this unit can do. And it could also help the owner, let's say, of the solar farm, ensure that he's getting the maximum return from obviously his investment in putting up this solar farm as well, because he wants to know that he's getting his return basically for investing heavily in the solar farm.
So in terms of people who would buy this, this instrument, is it more the electrical contractors and technicians, or is it the owners of the solar farms?
We've seen it in lots of different areas, and you're right in every one of those aspects you've just mentioned. On the smaller scale, yes, you'd have an owner of a particular farm, a solar farm, and then he may choose to own his own equipment. He may have the own team that maintain that as well, because whilst we're looking at it from an electrical perspective, they've obviously got various other things that need to take place with, obviously as basic as maybe cutting the grass around it and just cleaning them as well. So these electrical testers obviously form part of that, ensuring that it's obviously working and operating efficiently. So we see it from an owner. We also see it, as I say, from the electrical companies that are traditionally up and down the UK and Ireland. And what they do is this is an emerging market still, and we're seeing more of these come to the marketplace, let's say. There's becoming more demand. Some large companies, even some large contractors we're seeing, are now setting up separate divisions that actually are out there to take advantage of these contracts that are out there that can be awarded. And they're obviously being able to take advantage of this solar SMFT kit. And again, it solves a solution basically and helps obviously get the information from what they test into a device and then obviously take it through to reporting that information out.
Speaking of tests, the Fluke SMFT performs a lot of them. So just some of them. So like resistance, polarity, voltage, current, power, and diode. So, and it's also been optimized for ease of use. For instance, all the tests can be easily activated and are accompanied by on-screen instructions. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
And it also offers some automatic test sequences.
Yes.
So please, could you expand on these and perhaps explain why it's advantageous to have both automatic sequences and individual tests?
Sure. Okay. What happens is that when you go to test a solar farm, there is a like you've just rightly said, there's a sequence of mandatory tests that are expected to do in the way of compliance and conform to standards laid down. Those tests, as you rightly say, include insulation and grounding, which are, again, on commissioning, you might want to obviously do the connection and get it all grounded and then perform that test. That's why they operate them as an individual test. Makes sense. So obviously then as you move through and perform more, and then obviously as you start to energize circuits, you then might want to do load tests. So at different points of assembly or different points of testing might necessitate you do obviously just an individual test. If you've identified a potential fault with a panel or a module, as we say, then again, you might want to just do a test just on that one module. And therefore, again, you would do those individual tests that were necessary there. The benefit of the auto sequence is it goes through each of those tests in a cycle without you obviously having to return to the tester. And again, you can activate them using the one test lead solution here, where we connect the test leads up to the modules and it will cycle through the relevant tests that are applicable. So again, it's just about how the user wants to take advantage of the functionality of the tester to perform his jobs on the day.
Right, so it adds to the how user-friendly it is as well.
Of course, yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so I was just speaking of the auto sequences. Could you just explain what the CAT 1 full sequency safety testing and CAT 2 system performance testing would be used? Like, how would you use those?
Okay, well, the standard obviously laid down there says that there are a number of mandatory tests that we have. You touched on them earlier, yeah. Which is going to be the earth grounding, then an insulation, resistance, the power test, continuity, and the diode test. Those are six tests that are required to do to that standard on the DC side of the system. The second option is the optional tests, if you like, as well. So things like the IV curve and a thermographic survey, these are things you can add on to the testing of the service and obviously add to doing a full inspection of the facility.
The max system voltage for this is 1,000 volts.
1,000 volts on this unit, yes.
Okay. Yeah, so speaking of the IV curve, could you explain the advantages of that? Like, what will it show you? How is it useful?
Okay, the IV curve is designed to look at the output and performance of a panel or mm-hmm. module. What happens is that we know that for electrical safety, once we've been through all the electrical tests, that's fine, but we want to know now on the IV curve, are we getting the maximum return of solar energy from that panel coming out? And we measure that over what we call an IV curve. Mm-hmm. So it's looking there at current over voltage, basically, okay. Current and voltage. And what happens is each panel is manufactured to produce a certain amount of energy. So what we do is we compare that to what we call a standard test condition, an STC. And this is where they get 1,000 watts per meter squared. And what happens then, each of these modules then are scaled and then fall in with these tolerances against those standard test conditions to make sure you're getting the maximum return of energy from each module. And that's what people want to see from a good IV curve.
So it's more of more interest to the owner of the solar farm?
Potentially, yes. Because again, whoever owns that wants to make sure that their big solar farm is generating as much power as possibly, as efficiently as possible. Yeah. Once you start to see variations in the IV curve, it could be because of supplementary factors, there could be poor connections, there could be an element of silt or something that's formed on there, could be foliage that's growing by trees or whatever. So again, all these are variable factors, but the IV curve would obviously indicate whether there's any potential issues there, and just making sure the owners of that solar farm are getting the most from their return.
And one of the other functions that it includes that perhaps adds to its ease of use is the keep the leads function. Could you explain that, please?
Okay. Well, the keep the leads function is the last thing anybody wants is to be making a connection of test leads for one measurement, then moving them to a disconnect and put another set of test leads in. So keep the leads is a feature that the Fluke unit is able to take advantage of, and that also forms part of the auto test. So obviously, as you cycle through them, yeah. The leads are connected and allows that function to obviously utilize what's needed at any point. So you make the connection, you do the auto test, and it will cycle through with a minimal amount of effort from the user.
So it improves ease and efficiency.
Exactly.
So with the Fluke SMFT, there are two kits available. There's the standard kit and the pro kit. Mm-hmm. Please, could you go over what's included in each kit and what the difference between the kits?
The reason we've got two is, again, the unit itself, the SMFT, obviously that's a necessity. We have our Irradiance meter that comes with the unit. We have the power clamp as well. Mm-hmm. So that's the basic standard width. And then obviously you've got all the lead accessories and wander leads and connectors as you'd expect to have with this. And that's the kit form. When we come to the professional one, we added on the software features as well for this, which okay. aligns with the data that's captured from the unit. And we put that into our dedicated TrueTest software. The TrueTest software aligns with the module and has a two-way communication. Let's say that you go to a site or you're going to a site and you know that there's a certain type of modules there. From the TrueTest software, you can upload into the SMFT the modules that you're going to test. So it saves you that time mm-hmm. when you come and you just start to do those testing straight away. Once you've done the test, you can send it back to the TrueTest software from the unit. And again, they align. We tie it up with the client and site. And that allows you to obviously produce reports that can be utilized by anybody that's needed them. And that's why we have two kits, with and without the software.
And how does the software come? Is it just like a license code?
Yes, it is a license code, yes.
And so who would you recommend the two kits for? Who would you recommend a pro kit to, a standard kit to?
Okay, well, again, it's down to the individual user, basically. Mm-hmm. So obviously with software, you would only need to purchase one license of software, if you like, for one administrator. More administrators would need more licenses,
yeah.
And that makes sense. So that's why we have the software available there. As regards to the users, These can be everybody from a single electrician that's diversifying his market to a big FM company that's decided to win or has been awarded a contract, or down to some solar specialist. This is a one-stop toolkit, basically, that I would help everybody out and help them perform their jobs correctly.
And could you tell us a bit more about the Irradiance meter in the company, please?
Okay. Well, the Irradiance meter is a Bluetooth Irradiance meter. What that means is, obviously, you would have to take the Irradiance meter onto the panel. Has a little fixing unit here on the side, a bracket that fixes on the side, because you don't want it to be overlaid on top of any module or panel, because that's, again, straight away is going to impact the measurements you're taking. It's got a contact sensor on the back, and then with this as well, you could also hook up a temperature sensor that would go on the reverse of the panel or underneath. That way, again, it's not impeding it and it's taking a true measurement of what's actually happening. And because it's Bluetooth, obviously it'll work from a distance, with the operator being in one location. Maybe the solar panels might be on the roof of a building potentially, or at distance. So again, that connection is good. If for argument's sake the distance is too great, it would retain that information in it and then would send it across, obviously, when it's back within its connectivity distance. So that's the IR2 Bluetooth Irradiance meter. And then we have a power clamp. Power clamp is literally there for taking the AC and DC measurements either side of the inverter, because you want to look at your KVA values and you want to look at your KVAR values as well. So again, that data is all captured inside the meter as well.
So they all work via Bluetooth.
This is a hard connection with the clamp meter.
Sorry.
It's all right. That's okay. Yes, this one is connected via a lead, and the Irradiance meter is a Bluetooth connection.
Why should people pick a Fluke solar kit?
Okay. Well, the solar tester, again, we offer a complete solution. That's obviously a primary feature that we've got here as well. The synchronicity between, obviously, the Bluetooth Irradiance meter and then obviously the clamp, and obviously all this combined as a kit is one element. Working it also with the true test software means you can not just do solar, but it also connects to the pat testing modules for Fluke pat testers. And also, if you've got Fluke installation testers, you can use that in that module as well. So it means that you're keeping information from your Fluke family of instruments all in one location, potentially in the true test software. So that would be a strong remark as well. And it just ties everything nicely together.
So in addition to these two, the clamp meter and the Irradiance meter, could the multifunction tester work with other Fluke tools, or is it just those two?
This one is a standalone tool. This one is purely based for solar testing, but obviously these meters here help ascertain the appropriate measurements that need to be taken to give a performance rating for the solar panel. So this is one kit solution. That's why it acts as its own solar module set.
I'm just going to clarify, you can't use this for normal multifunction testing, can you?
No, you can't. No. The measurements are different, even though it's encased in the same unit as our 1600 series. Multifunctional testers, they look obviously the same, and they also do very similar tests. But no, this is definitely an independent unit.
Yeah. So is there anything else we should know about the Fluke SMFT1000?
The one thing that's probably worth noting as well is, in the true test I mentioned about software and the module data. The module data is retained within the true test software, which Fluke obviously update on a routine basis. As new modules come to market, we put more and more into that database there. So it's a what we'll call a living document. Mm-hmm. And that just makes, obviously, future-proofing it as well. And the units are always upgradable as well through the software. So again, it just makes it a nice solution and gives you as much future-proofing as we possibly can.
So if you could describe the Fluke MSFT in three words, what would they be?
Reliable, accurate, and easy to use.
Thank you for introducing us to the Fluke SMFT Solar Multifunction PV Tester. I hope that's been helpful. If you want to know any more information, please visit our website, www.tester.co.uk.